as we roll down this unfamiliar road. And although this wave is stringing us along, just know you're not alone, 'cause I'm gonna make this place your home.
Welcome home, everybody. I'm glad that everyone is back, and I hope you had a great summer and that everyone is looking forward to coming back and getting back into the school year, and you're looking forward to it as much as I'm looking forward to having all of you back in the school. Summer's great. I love summer. I love the heat. I love swimming. I love being outside and golfing and all the other things you do in the summer, but it's really quiet here in school, and I always look forward to everyone coming back and having that energy and excitement back into school. I tell freshmen every year that in 4 years, my goal is that when you graduate and you leave this school, that you feel like this place was your home and everyone here was your family. And I really believe that. It's been my home for 25 years. Last week, I received a nice little plaque from Mr. Wagner to congratulate me for 25 years in the district. And it's a beautiful plaque. That's the outside of this was made by our manufacturing class last year. Probably the nicest thing I've ever seen come out of the manufacturing class. It's a beautiful thing I'm going to hang up on my wall. But I didn't need anything to reward me for being here for 25 years, because just being here alone is my reward for 25 years. I love this place. I love Wilson. For me, it really is like a family. We have that kind of a friendly family atmosphere in our school. Over the past like 3 years, because of COVID, I think it's been harder to have that same kind of atmosphere. We've had to cancel all kind of things because of COVID. We didn't have a pep rally in 3 years because of COVID. We had social distancing. We had to cancel other things. Homecoming was different than it had been. And because of all of that, like, one of my fears, I guess, is that we're going to have students that are graduating that never really had that full feeling of what it's like to have that kind of atmosphere in our school. So our goal this year is get back to normal as much as we can and make sure that everyone that graduates, whether you're a freshman, junior, sophomore, senior, no matter what it is, that you graduate from here and feel like this place was your home and we're all one big family. And hopefully we can do that this year, because the good news is pretty much all COVID restrictions are completely gone, which is great. And I am looking forward to a relatively normal school year. Great news with that is we are having a pep rally. First time in 3 years. This Thursday, we're going to kick off the year with our regular back-to-school pep rally and really get things back to normal again. We're going back to 3 lunches. We don't have to separate everybody and have 4 lunches anymore. The nice thing of that is when students are leaving the cafeteria and students are coming in, it's not happening at the same time. You're not going to have that big log jam of kids trying to come and go into the cafeteria at the same time. We're going to have about a 15-minute gap between lunches, which means we can clean the tables before students are coming in and eating. What a nice thing that'll be. It's not going to be gross that you're eating off a table that 4 people before you sat in that same spot and ate in that same spot. So all of those little things are going to be really nice little additions and things that we could do. You no longer have to quarantine if you're a close contact with somebody that did end up getting COVID. Really, it is going to be hopefully a completely normal school year, and we're going to initiate a lot of the things that we hadn't been able to do in the past. Field trips, assemblies, all that sort of stuff is all back, and we're going to be back to normal. One bad news item that comes with being back to normal is for the past 2 years, lunch and breakfast has been free. And unfortunately, that is gone. That is one of the bad things that comes with being back to normal. There are 2 things that I kind of want to point out with that. I wish lunches and breakfast was still free. It was great. You can come in, grab the food you need, and eat and be good to go. 2 things that I kind of want to point out is now that you have to pay for your lunch and for your breakfast, make sure that you put money on your account and that you use your ID card and scan as you go through that lunch line. You're going to have to do that. You're going to notice probably today that those lunch lines are going to be long. Everything's going to move a little bit slow because we're not used to that. And we're going to have people that don't have their accounts with money on them. We're going to have people that don't have their ID badges. I would encourage everyone, get all that stuff set up as soon as you can to make those lunches flow by as soon as you can, and you're not going to be standing in a line as long. So make sure you get money on your account, make sure you have your ID, and you're ready to go down and pay for your lunch through your ID badge. Another thing is, this morning you're going to get a piece of paper that's going to tell you how to apply for free and reduced lunch. Make sure you do that. If you think you're eligible for free and reduced lunch, doggone it, go and get that free and reduced lunch and get the free lunch that you had in previous years. So if you think you're eligible for it, take that form, fill it out, bring it back, and then hopefully you can get yourself back onto a free and reduced lunch again. 2 other things that we implemented because of COVID that we're keeping that have really nothing to do with COVID, but we're keeping it because we think it's better. One of those things is, in the past, students used to come in the morning between 7 and 7:30, and everybody was forced into the cafeteria, and we had 400 kids standing in the cafeteria until 7:30 in the morning until we opened up the hallways for them to go to class. Because of COVID, we had implemented homerooms instead. Instead, if you come between 7 and 7:30, everyone was assigned a homeroom, not for attendance or anything like that. It was just a place to sit so that we didn't have 400 or 500 kids in the cafeteria. We are having that again this year. Again, not because of COVID, because it's better. Instead of having 500 kids in the cafeteria at the same time, you have a place to go and sit. If you do want breakfast in the morning, that's fine. You can come in, you go get your breakfast in the cafeteria, and then you take that breakfast back to that homeroom, and you could eat in that room. You don't have to sit in the cafeteria to eat. You can go and eat in that homeroom. Another thing that we implemented because of COVID that we're keeping is one-way hallways. And I know when you first hear that, you might think that's a terrible idea, but it's actually a really good idea. We have almost 800 kids in the school this year. When there's 800 kids in this school is very, very crowded. We've had 800 kids in the past, and I can tell you, you get these big log jams in the hall, especially by the stairwells when everyone's coming and going at the same time. And it is very, very hard to walk through the hall because you have these jams of people in the hall. So we're keeping one-way hallways because the halls will flow much smoother like that, and you're not going to have those big jams of kids. Because it has nothing to do with COVID, okay, it is not that you need to do it or you get in trouble or anything like that. If you're in room 106, for example, and you need to go to room 104, walk the wrong way down the hall, that's fine. You're going one direction, that's fine. The idea is we want the majority of people flowing the same way in the hall so that you don't get those big log jams. Again, nothing to do with COVID, but I think it makes it better. I'm going to turn things over to Mr. Beitler, but before I do that, I just want to kind of say again, I'm really glad that you're back. I look forward to talking to you all again. I haven't seen you in a while, and welcome home and have a great year.
Good morning, Wilson. Welcome back to the 22-23 school year out here, trying to get my last amount of sun, get my last vitamin D that I'm going to get here. As you come in, I don't know if you ever take a notice, but outside it does say enter to learn. go forth to serve. It is our motto. If you haven't taken a look at it, you probably have not seen actually the fine print. The fine print that is added years and years ago. You probably haven't seen it, but it does actually say enter to learn on time. On time being the important part. If you didn't know, we open the doors at 7 o'clock in the morning and you need to be in your class by 7:40. My recommendation is if you are walking or if you're driving, you're shooting for about 7:30. 7:30 allows you enough time to come in, allows you to scan in, allows you to get into class on time. So when the 7:40 bell rings, you're actually there, you are ready to learn. So let's talk a little bit about the mornings when you come in. When you come in the building in the morning, you know you need to scan in. We give you a lot of IDs. You need to have an ID. This morning, Christmas City sent all of our students an email that has your ID, so you have an electronic email. Our scanners, when you walk in the morning, will scan a regular ID. It'll scan any kind of barcode. It will scan your phone. That's what it's designed to do. The issue that we have is if you forget it. Well, we give you so many of them. This morning, we're going to give you a regular ID. Some people have keychains. Some people are going to have stickers, but it is also on your phone. The new this year as well is that on your phone, if you have the Skyward app, your ID is actually in your Skyward app. All right, you need to be logged in as you, not your parent. Your parent doesn't have your ID, you have your ID. So when you're logged into the Skyward app under your name, your ID is there. There are really no reasons why you should forget your ID. All right. So when you come in, say good morning to me, say good morning to Mr. Morticelli, say good morning to all the teachers who are there. Try to get in around 7:30. If you come before 7:30, that's great. You want to get some breakfast, grab some breakfast, and you need to head up to homeroom. You can eat your breakfast up there at homeroom. But hey, let's shoot for 7:30 so that way you can be in your classroom by 7:40. I'm holding a yellow gold sheet right here. We do have the study hall privilege this year. The study hall privilege is going to be opened up to 10th, 11th, and 12th graders to start the year. If you have a study hall and then you meet our grading requirements and our expectations, 70% or above in all of your classes, you can leave for your study hall. You can come late and scan in if you have block one study hall. You can leave early for the day if you have block four study hall. If you have study hall block two or three, you can gladly scan out. If you meet the 70 or above, you can scan out, go home, rest a little bit, do a little bit of your work, and then come back on time for your next class. I will come around to every single study hall the next 2 days. I will hand these sheets out because your parents need to sign off on it. Your parents need to agree that it's okay that you either come late, leave early, or that way you leave the campus. So right now it's only open to 10, 11, and 12th graders. Freshmen, it will be open to you hopefully second semester. I want to get you in here. I want you to get accustomed to the high school. We want your grades obviously be high enough. You need to prove it to us that you can handle the huge responsibility to come late, leave early, leave during the day, and you can come back. Prove to us that you have what it takes, and we will give you this privilege on you, hopefully your second semester. More to come on that later in the year. So really, I'm happy everyone's back. It's been a little quiet recently. Come on time, you know, give 100%. Our teachers are ready to give 100% to you. We're going to have a great year. More to come. You're going to see me on announcement. Once again, welcome back, Wilson.